Adam Rayner for Angus Mill TV. Out there, Canada Goose. It's floating around in a lake here at Ivel Valley Fisheries. Now, this used to be down the end of a really intrepid, bumpy, horrible old farm track. Now, Lafarge have actually built an awesomely beautiful river of tarmac down to here. But it is still a good way off the beaten track. And you have to really earn your place down here at the bottom of the track. There's my new mate Dan here now. Hello, Dan, you're
right, mate.
You've been fishing down here a couple of years, haven't you?
Yeah, a good few years, about 3 years now, yeah, 4 years.
Tell us about the stock in here, what have you got?
There's carp to about 25, 26, so other people have caught. I've caught about 3 or 4 20s down here in my time. You've got a lot of decent ghosties that go to sort of 19, 20 pounds.
Oh, they're worthy.
Yeah. And
that's a proper shout about it across the lake, ghosty 20 pound, isn't
that's it? That's it, yeah. You've got a lot of fish in here that are just under 20. They don't quite push 20 sometimes, but they're lovely to catch, good fight, good strong fish. And you've got a couple of catfish in here also. No one really knows exactly how many. I think there's, it was caught last year by 58, just under 60 pounds. There's a couple in here around 40, 50 pounds. You've got lots of tench, lots of bream, there's loads of silverfish for pole anglers, and also we're just doing a bit of pike fishing at the minute, so there's pike up to 15 pound as well. So
worthy piking.
Yeah.
And of course it's kind of wintry now, which is yeah, there's no leaves on the trees, but a beautiful woodlined fishery.
Yeah, you've got some nice features up here. I mean, the harvester, which is behind us, that's got more of a straight sort of lake feature, the same as the day ticket, slightly wider. You've got around the back on the members section, you've got a lot more of a shape. You've got a horseshoe sort of shape to a couple of swims, and there's some lovely sort of secluded swims around there. Get more of the lake to yourself, but you've got nets that divide up the lake, but they don't seem to affect the fish. They seem to get around all the parts
they
of the lake.
They get where they want to get to.
They get through the nets. I think there must be holes in the nets. Yes. So the fish are spread around, and you generally find all year round, if you move around the lake, you catch something really, even this time of year. I mean, I'm going for the pike, but you still will catch this time of year.
And I mean, how much these things cost? What does it cost to fish here, Governor?
The membership for a year is £195, I believe. It's the same as last year, and I think it's £9 for a day ticket and £18, £17, something like that for a night fish.
Yes, that's pretty damn keen. That's on the money, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's well worth it for the value, yeah, for the money.
You've got some big old beasts in here as well.
Yeah, there is some, like I say, for the catfish. If you're a catfish angler, it's definitely a good place to come in the summer.
Have you seen the video I made with the Eastern European fellow? It says, for me, it's huge fish.
No.
£53 cat. He's a good lad, though.
Yeah.
Dan, thank you ever so much. That's lovely. So, no Ivel Valley here. And just remains for me to exhort the viewer to check us out every Tuesday. All Good News Agents, there's a virtual version. Love us up on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Adam Rayner and Dan signing out here at Ivel Valley. Thanks ever so much, Dan.
Cheers, thank you.